the Soviet Union, its full name being the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics. We all know this story. World War I happened, the people didn't like the Tsar, and then communism. Yay! But hold it right there, bucko, because this is the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics. And how all these countries became one is a long story that I am generalizing and condensing into a short video. So buckle up, kids, it's time to go on Mr. Stalin's wild ride. All this started with World War I and Russia's participation in it. There was a famine, there was a war, people were dying, and the people wanted to not die. So they had a revolution to set up a government that would allow them to not die. The revolution between Tsar supporters and Tsar haters was also a civil war between Tsar haters and Tsar haters that liked the color red. During this political chaos, Ukraine was like, ah, political instability, better use this opportunity to gain independence. But there were many different people fighting in this. Republicans, anarchists, people who didn't actually want to leave, people who weren't even Ukrainian because World War I was still going on, and also communists. Obviously, the also communists were helped by the red-loving Tsar haters. Because of this, they won and the Ukrainian Soviet Socialist Republic was formed. Then we have Belarus, who saw the Russian Revolution and was like, ah, political instability, better use this opportunity to gain independence, and basically did the same thing as Ukraine, except much more peaceful and also not that communist. But the red-loving Tsar haters didn't like this and set up a different Belarus government. After some time, the two merged into the Belarus Soviet Socialist Republic. So the red-loving Tsar haters won the revolution slash civil war and formed the Russian Soviet Federation of Socialist Republics, or the RSFSR. Then the RSFSR went to the Ukrainian SSR and the Belarusian SSR, and together formed the USSR. Rewinding a bit, the revolution was happening alongside World War I, and the Germans were still invading. They went to the Soviets and said, hey, Soviets, how about a deal? And the Soviets said, no. So they kept fighting. Then the Germans said, how about now? And the Soviets said, fine. This was the Treaty of Brest-Litovsk. This, plus the Treaty of Versailles, made Finland, Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania, and Ukraine independent. We know what happened to Ukraine already, but the rest wouldn't become important until the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact in 1939, where the USSR would get Finland, Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania as part of their sphere of influence. The USSR took these countries, turned them into SSRs, and then added them to the USSR. Except Finland, where the USSR did take part of it. And that was turned into the Karelian SSR, later merged with RSFSR. Okay, so next up is the Caucasus, and this is going to be really generalized. Like, this is way too much information to put in this video and still have it be a short video amount of generalization. So, the Transcaucasian Democratic Federative Republic is formed out of the Russian Civil War. This broke apart into Georgia, Armenia, and Azerbaijan. These got turned into SSRs, which then united into a Transcaucasian Socialist Federative Socialist Republic. This joined the USSR, then broke apart into the SSRs again. Next up is Central Asia, which is even more generalization. So Turkestan is a part of the Russian Empire. The Russian Empire becomes RSFSR, and Turkestan stays a part of RSFSR, but now is an autonomous republic, but not independent. This breaks into the Uzbek, Turkmen, and Tajik SSRs, all joining the USSR because of Stalin. So thanks, Stalin. Then there's also the Kara Kyrgyz Autonomous Oblast, which becomes the Kara Kyrgyz Autonomous Oblast, which becomes the Kyrgyz Autonomous Socialist Soviet Republic, which becomes the Kyrgyz Soviet Socialist Republic, now a part of the USSR and secretly Kyrgyzstan. But we still have one more left to do, and that is Kazakhstan, which was in the Russian Empire, briefly had independence as the Alash Autonomy, then back to the new Soviet Russia as the Kyrgyz ASSR, then renamed the Kazakhs ASSR, then joined the USSR as the Kazakh Soviet Socialist Republic. And that is all the SSRs of the USSR. Complicated countries within a complicated country. Just like Prussia, with all their kingdoms. But that's a story for another video.